Musicals, though I grew up in Spokane, where all they've done is grow apples since the day the world began. So I hid my feelings for apples, it's a skill I learned to hone. And as I grew, I guess I knew I'd always be alone. But I've always liked oranges from my earliest memories, even though there's no orange trees in Washington State. I was shy and minded my business, then I met Mike one day. He seemed so nice, so I broke the ice and found the nerve to say, I've always liked oranges. Crap! What a strange conversation start. He said, dude, here's the strangest part. I like oranges too. We're two guys who like oranges, who are sent a clear message like this. We don't have to like apples. Oranges are great. That moment left quite an impression. That moment a light bulb went off. I remembered the years of repression and my worries that people would scoff. All those times that I tried liking apples seemed at once like a meaningless waste. And I learned there with Mike that you like what you like, and there's just no accounting for taste. Now we're proud to like oranges, and we walk with our heads held high, because I found another guy who loves the things that I love.
And so did I. We both love oranges.
He's so handsome.
And he's awfully cute.
If you're looking for morals, we'll give it a shot.
There are those who like apples and those who do not.
So whatever your preference, embrace what you've got. It's a big